is Olympic judo with 1 versus 3. Azerbaijan and Czech Republic. This is a battle for gold and silver in Rio. Azerbaijan and the Czech Republic. Gasimov and Krupaljak.
Straight into the attack, Krupaljak. Oh, that's a Yuko straight away for Krupaljak. He meant business then, didn't he?
Wow.
And, Gasimov tried to counter him, but he didn't have a chance.
He's not done with yet.
No, well, this is where he's strongest. You know, down on the ground is exactly where he's strongest. And I don't understand that. And the crowd know as well that exactly that that's where he's strongest. And Krupaljak wanted to carry on.
So the score taken away.
Oh, they've taken the...
Yeah, I think that's what they...
That's what it was about.
The
they've taken the score out. So they must have had a look at it on the video referee, and he must have just landed on his front rather than his side.
Nevertheless, we all know the intentions, if we didn't already.
Well, we do. Krupaljak means business. But he'll have to be careful of the counter-attack. Straight in again, Krupaljak. Oh, and that's what he's got to be careful for. And Gasimov there trying the Yoko Otoshi side sacrifice technique where he absolutely uses his whole weight and his body there to try and take Krupaljak over. Right against left. How rangy does Krupaljak look? And now Gasimov. Gasimov tries to take him backwards. Krupaljak certainly getting stronger and stronger. This is the best I've seen him since the time he won the world title.
2 years previous to that in London, a top seven finish for Krupaljak. And first, it's the same finish in the Olympic Games in London for Gasimov. And someone's going to be extremely happy and someone's still going to be happy, but right now, no one's thinking about a silver. It means nothing to them in the heat of battle like this.
Yeah, they're both of them. The Olympic Games didn't go for them in London. Krupaljak can't do what he just did there anymore. Unless he breaks the balance of Gasimov, he can't just sacrifice himself without breaking balance. You've got to break balance. So you've got to move your partner no matter what you do. It's like the foot sweeps as well. You can't just tap at the legs. You've got to move your opponent. It's got to have a meaning to it. Well, I haven't seen Gasimov. Now, Gasimov's got to attack. Krupaljak just ahead on attacks, but no score on the board. It's all even and anybody's match. Who's going to commit? It's who commits now. And he's a little bit hesitant going in there at this moment. Krupaljak felt the danger of the counter-attack.
That's the thing about Gasimov, isn't it? I think a number of people today have sort of talked themselves out of it. He's such a steely force when you stand toe-to-toe with him. He looks like he can do anything. We know he can do anything, and they've sometimes, particularly early, almost talked themselves out of it.
Yeah, well, he looks down and out. He looks as if he's finished sometimes, and then he explodes, and that's what he does. His head goes down. He looks like he's tired. You think, oh, I'm going to have a go at it here, and then he'll punish you. Another good technique there from Gasimov. Tries to get the follow-up there to get Krupaljak onto his side, and it doesn't happen. Yeah, his coach is telling him, you've got to pull him in, got to stop him from moving. He's getting a little bit of space there, the Azerbaijan fighter. And Gasimov, that's what he operates off. He needs that little bit of space, especially when he does the side sacrifice. Now Krupaljak can go. He needs to pull Gasimov's head in. Tries the sumigaeshi. Sacrifices himself this time. Wow, what a match.
The referee. I thought there might have been something coming. No, nothing from the referee. Slow to get up. The first victory today for Gasimov was against Kalbulay of Russia. And that's just not any Russian name. That's the defending gold medalist from London. He beat him in his very first match.
Well, that was close as well. Krupaljak then just went in and Gasimov was looking for the counter technique. He's got to make sure it's strong. Krupaljak knows that though. 1 minute 26, everything to fight for. It's the Olympic title.
A long way to go, but also not that far at all. Golden score, a distinct possibility to decide the gold and silver medals here in Brazil 2016.
Yeah, well, they're both defending well. You were talking about attacking and defending. They're both defending very, very well. You can see there's no penalties on there. They're attacking well, and they're going for it. And I said that Kapelic can't do that again. He definitely can't do that. I don't know whether he'll get away with that without a penalty going against him. 53 seconds to go. I think the referee will let it go because there was intent there. Big arm over. Now Kapelic. Oh, almost then again. He moved him this time and there was a clash as they went down.
Clash of heads.
I think
head
so.
Head versus nose. That's got to hurt, and you can see it does. It did hurt. Good defence. He was in all sorts of trouble, or so it seemed, Gassimov, to get himself out of that. And well, he was strong with that grip over the top. He'll try that again. If he can get a hold again, you'd back in the man from Czech Republic, wouldn't you?
Yeah, well, he wants to go forward again. Kapelic coming forwards and Gassimov looking for the counter. The Azeri team, all of them can counter well. That big left arm over the top there. Kapelic again. Oh, it's going to be it. Kapelic scores it on. He is the Olympic champion. That was absolutely amazing. Absolute. Oh, look at that. Everybody celebrates and he gets the Olympic title there with an amazing technique. And I've got to say that he fully deserved that. He was the one that was opening up and it was Gassimov waiting and waiting and waiting. It never happened. Ouchi Gari, he drives him backwards and what an ippon that was in this final. Kapelic is the Olympic champion.
What a magic moment it is for each and every athlete. The 25-year-old wife Eva, I think, up in the stands. He's a man who likes to live on the edge. He loves riding his motorbikes, but nothing beats this thrill. No bike can go fast enough to replicate the feeling right now of becoming an Olympic champion. Lukas Kapelic. Oh, that's a wonderful scene. These two, oh, look at that. That is beautiful. They really went at it, didn't they? And in the end, that is great. Gassimov, not strong enough, the world number one. And there's a new man on top of the table. And there he is.
Lukas Kapelic, Olympic champion. And those scenes there say it all, full of tears.
Oh, the camera picking up the sound. We see the emotion now, the sound of glory. That's what that was.
Oh, it was just unbelievable. And those two coming together after that fight, it was an epic fight, it really was. They were both going for it. It was an Olympic title at stake, but they were both going for it. They both wanted it. And, well, Kapelic was the one that got it. And look at that, he salutes everybody in the crowd as every one of these people do. And they just can't believe it, he can't believe it. And that is the best I've seen him for a long, long time. He was unbelievable, back to his very, very best. What a time to do it. It was always going to be wide open, this under 100 kilos category, because there were so many people that could have done it. But Kapelic, well, he took the fight to everybody and well, he is a great champion, a world champion, and now an Olympic champion, and he did it in style.
Medalha de ouro e campeão olímpico representando a República Tcheca.
Lukas Kapelic.
And the golden Czech, Lukas Kapelic, 25 years of age, 2014 world champion, 2016 Olympic champion.
Yeah, that was amazing. It's the best I've seen him for a long, long time.